It's like a newborn child needs nourishment and a 16-year-old needs nourishment, but they are not the same. The kind of nourishment that the senior devotees, you know, people in the movement for last 30, 40 years, they need their protection, their encouragement, their inspiration, their fulfillment, purpose, their contribution, for it to be, you know, also be overseen. Like, for example, one of the devotee care is care for leadership. Leaders are doing everything. Are they being cared for? Their needs, is it being addressed? Because people expect everything from the leader till the person drops. And only then say, oh yeah, I think we should have done it. So every level of devotee needs different levels of care. So that's, I think, the main issue here that needs to be thought and implemented.
Yes. So in a sense, we can say our movement is evolving, and then as we grow, we also recognizing what the needs of our community are. And then we are creating whatever resources are possible for dealing with those needs, for addressing those needs. And devotee care is
absolutely
one major initiative that has come up. Now, in the manual, as you said, it is, there's a wealth of wisdom over there. One of the things that struck out for me is that it talks about not just being spiritually well situated, but also being materially well situated. So at first glance, it was, I appreciated, but I didn't just appreciate the point. I appreciated the courage required to make that point. So to some extent, you know, we have been quite dismissive about life's material aspect. Like even if, say, devotees face problems, we say this is just a confirmation that this world is dukkhale, so get out of here. Just work hard to get out of here. But actually, we have a long life to live. And we need also care for that. So, you know, so can you explain how this idea of being materially well-situated came up? I appreciate that, but what was the experience or what was the thought behind recognizing that devotees need to be materially well-situated?
Well, the vision statement of the devotee care endeavor, the effort, is in the present tense. This is what we want to see. How does a caring society look like? You know? So the vision statement is, every devotee is spiritually happy and materially or properly situated.
Okay.
Positively identifying with ISKCON as a caring society. Each devotee responsibly takes care of his diverse needs, is easily and successfully able to get qualified help within the institution, and wholeheartedly sharing that with others.
That's a lot.
Janma sarthaka kari karo paro.
Okay.
Yeah, so every word has been so wonderfully thought over and put there. So, what does it mean? Because generally, when we speak about materially well situated, whenever I have done this, some people have argued. In fact, there is one section where a debate is conducted. You know, being materially well situated is not just unfavorable, but rather impediment to spiritual progress. Yasaham anugrahami harishetad. You know, so we have debates. And then generally, as soon as we say materially well situated, people think about comforts. People think about fulfilling their wants. People think about wealth, possessions. But really well situated means being properly situated in your particular varna and ashram. so that you can contribute a lifelong during your whole life. Generally, I quote for these Bhagavad Gita 3.33. Sadrisham cheshtate swasyaha prakritir jnanamanapi prakritim yanti bhutani nigraha kim karishati. So this is a very important verse, and the whole purport I read where Prabhupada says artificially trying to repress doesn't work. And I also quote this 8.7 Bhagavad Gita. Mam anusmara yudhyacha. Internally you think of me, but externally fight. I also quote this 8th canto, 2nd chapter, 30th verse of Bhagavatam. Where there is a fight between Gajendra and crocodile. And Gajendra is extremely powerful and is fighting a long battle. But gradually it says, mana balo ojasa. He became weak in his mind, in his senses, and his sensual power, because he was not properly situated. He was in the water fighting for a long time. And because the crocodile was in the water, in his natural situation, his strength increased. Exactly opposite happened. And Prabhupada writes, beautiful, I would like to, actually, I knew someone like you will ask such kind of questions. So, I generally keep it for, especially I work, because sometimes people ask this. In the fighting between elephant and the crocodile, the difference was that although the elephant was extremely powerful, he was in a foreign place in the water. During 1,000 years of fighting, he could not get any food, and under the circumstances, his bodily strength diminished. And because his bodily strength diminished, his mind also became weak and his senses less powerful. The crocodile, however, being an animal of the water, had no difficulties. He was getting food and was therefore getting mental strength and sensual encouragement. Then Prabhupada says, now from this we may take the lesson that in our fight with Maya, we should not be in a position in which our strength, enthusiasm, and senses will be unable to fight vigorously. So that position is materially well situated or properly situated. The soldiers in this Krishna consciousness movement must always possess physical strength, enthusiasm, and sensual power. To keep themselves fit, they must therefore place themselves in a normal condition of life. This is very important. What constitutes a normal condition will not be the same for everyone. And therefore, there are divisions of Varnashram. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and Sannyas. And then this last statement I would like to quote. That one has been found to be very weak in one place does not mean that he should stop fighting the crocodile of Maya. One should take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna, as we shall see Gajendra do. You know? So, we may lose the battle, but the war must go on. So truly, materially well situated means physically, mentally, emotionally, socially, and spiritually, you need to go on. I would like to share with you one statement. I think His Holiness Radhana Swami was asked in some place to speak about the principles of devotee care. And he made, while speaking, he just kind of made a statement, what I thought can be written as a question that leaders should always be asking if they want to institute devotee care in the institution or the yatra or the community. He said, the leader should be asking this question. What would it take for each and every particular devotee to feel protected, encouraged, and inspired to remain active in the mission of Srila Prabhupada till the last day of their life? And whatever is the answer, do that. And that is devotee care.